read in the book of Judges, chapter 16, verse 21. And the Lord's Spirit could not stay in the heart of Samson because he threw his body for alcohol and for prostitution. He was going woman after woman, and the Holy Spirit said, I cannot stay with you. And the Bible says the Holy Spirit left him. The moment the Spirit of God left him, the enemy entered into him. That's why the Bible says in the book of Leviticus, chapter 6, verse 13, in the heart, in the altar of your heart, take care that the fire of the Holy Spirit remain with you. In the altar of your heart is the altar for God. Take care that the presence of God lives in you. At the altar of your heart, the fire of the Holy Spirit remains with you. The moment the fire goes away, what will be there in the stove? Hello? What will be there in the stove if there is no fire? You are all cooking women. Huh? What will be there? Huh? If there is no fire, what will be there? Nothing will be there. Ashes will not be there. And the snakes love ashes. The moment fire is not in you, the snakes will come to eat the ashes. They are just waiting. When will the fire? When will this person stop praying? When will this person start to blaming around God, blaming around this person, that person will enter. Tuck, gone. Yes. You may have very many techniques, but techniques don't help you. Only Holy Spirit helps you. Take care of the Spirit of God whom He has trusted and given to you. A man used to bring 12 feet snake and play with the people, show to people, and earn plenty of money. And he will bring out the snake out, and he will put his hands. The snake doesn't bring the poison as it bites. As soon as it bites, it catches the flesh and it begins to chew it. And the blood and the poison gets into the blood, and immediately persons get the effect of it. He knew the technique. So he used to put, as the snake hits, he used to take it away. 3 times he used to do, and then he will put back the snake. He knows how to catch, put it back. And he was there, became very famous. So many people used to come, and they used to give plenty of money. After putting the snake, then he will collect the money. Or sometimes he will make the snake to dance, and he will not allow anybody to come near, and he will go and he will ask his wife or somebody to collect. One man asked, he said, can you also play with the snake where it sleeps? Where you keep the snake. Because if you go and disturb there also, it will get very angry. So he gives enough food for the snake. He gives enough rest. And then he brings only particular time. The snake will be down in spirit. Now he said, yes. One fellow said, I will give you $1,000 if you can do the same. Said, okay. He put the snake inside the hood, and then he pulled the snake. Snake came very angrily. He showed his hand. It hit. He took it. Second time he put the hand, that man said, you are very great. Take my $1,000. So, as the snake was hitting, instead of taking, he turned to get the money. The snake got hold of the flesh and he died there only. He got the 1,000 rupees, but he lost his life. The snake never left him, nicely chewed him, and then with that anger it went back. He died. Many people think, nobody knows what I do, I can escape. In the world I can play around. Then afterwards, after becoming old, I can return back to God. You cannot. Many people don't take care of the Spirit of God. They don't understand the love of God giving His Spirit to us. They think we can play around. Afterwards, we can return back. There was a famous actress during the time of God's servant Modi in England. Not our Prime Minister Modi. He is a servant of God, Modi, in England. And he heard in a particular town, a film actress, through her way of living, many people are falling into sin. And being a Christian, she is doing that and leading many people to sin. Having realized that, he wanted to talk to her. He went and went to her house. She was surprised. Such a famous servant of God who does miracles and wonders. Servant of God, Modi. Moody, his name is M-O-O-D-I. Moody. He came to her house. So, servant of God, Moody, said, look, my dear daughter, because of you, the way you dress, the way you behave in the film, and the way you talk, many people are led into sin. So, change your way of life. Your life is a gift of God. And only what you do is your gift to God. Take care. Your life doesn't become an obstacle for people to grow in God. She said, oh, now I am young. Now only I get the chance. I got this call sheet, I have to go this film, that act. And as soon as this all will be over, after 30, 32 at the most, or 40, afterwards nobody will call me. Then the entire life of mine, I can serve God, I can do as God wishes. Meanwhile, she brought nice coffee and gave it to servant of God, Moody. When she said, after 40, after all these call sheets are over, I will come and serve God. The servant of God was drinking his coffee. He drank only half, and then the rest of the coffee he gave to her. Please drink. She got angry. What do you think? Because you are servant of God, you can do whatever you wish to. You drank with your mouth and you give the coffee to me. He said, cool down, my dear daughter. Your body is God's gift to you. You want to play with your body and throw it to anybody and everybody, and your body is destroyed in the world with the lust, and then the used body, you want to give it to God? She came to her senses. She began to weep and cry. That day she gave up everything of hers and she followed the Lord. She became later a famous preacher. Life is once. Remember the love of God. He loved you and me and gave his only son. And that son died and shed his precious blood for us. Because we all die in our sin. Though God has formed us, sin deforms us.